Hey, what's going on, YouTube? It's your man, McCrae, the four here with a sneaker-related video. I know I've been gone for a while, but I've been doing a lot of things. If you don't know already, I'm in the military, United States Air Force, and I have to, do my duties to protect this country. So, anyway, I'm back. I have been copping sneakers left and right, but right now, I want to respond to a video that Newt Mechanics have posted a while ago. Sneaker prices, have we done this to ourselves? And yes, we have. I kind of want to support what he's saying. And I actually want to make my case to prove that we have done this to ourselves. All right? Now, the shoe that dropped today, because today is April 28th, 2012. The shoe that dropped today were the Elite Series shoes. Everybody knows what it is because they already hyped up the shoe a lot on Nice Kicks, Kicks on Fire, whatever, in the sneaker community, all over Twitter and Facebook, alright? And the point I want to get at is how in the hell did the Hyperdunks go from about a buck 20 to $200? That's an $80 difference. LeBron's went from 170 for the nines to 250, and the only shoe that didn't go up that much, too much, but still went up, were the Kobe Sevens, the Elite Series. Now, I can't see myself paying, and let's get this straight. All right, I can't see myself paying $200 for the Elite Hyperdunks when they look like this. These are the 2010s. Oh, but they look different. They're supposed to be the Elite. No, they're not. Same material, same fly wire material across here. All they did was change the cosmetics. They put some gold on there. They put it's all it is just a cosmetically updated 2011 Hyperdunk, as if the Hyperdunks haven't even gone that far in the future. These are 2010s. They still look like the 2011s. All right, just different look on it, but it's the same Hyperdunk background. Okay, I can't shed any light on the Kobe's because the Kobe system, I'm gonna sound like I'm kind of defending it, but the Kobe system, you're getting the, if they even come with it, the different insoles. Now, I've tried out the Kobe Sevens, the Kobe Elite Sevens, and it's the same as the regular Kobe Sevens. I have the Sharks. Same shoe, all right, but that price is almost there, but not as ridiculous as the Hyperdunks and the LeBron's gone. Now, I can't see myself paying $250 for these, and these are the LeBron 8PS series. Oh, but McCray, what are you saying? The LeBron 9 Elites are, they got the lightweight material and carbon fiber all over the side of the shoe and the gold swoosh and the 180 air unit, the sole of the shoe looks really good. It's an updated version of this shoe right here. Okay? These are the LeBron 8PS series. Why do I bring these out? Because the LeBron 9s are the shoes that LeBron played with in the regular season, okay? LeBron 8s, they were the shoe that LeBron played with in the regular season. LeBron 8 PS series came out right before the playoffs. LeBron 9 Elite series are coming out before the playoffs. Now, let me get this straight. All right, quote me if I'm wrong. Correct me if I'm wrong. Excuse me. The LeBron 8 version 2s were $160, if I'm right. Okay? If I'm right. These right here were 150. And just to prove it, that they were 150, let me pull out the box right quick. Because I got the actual box, okay? Oh, actually, hold on, sorry. It's kind of folded. Okay? Take a look at that. What does that say? Suggested retail, 150. Okay? Do you see where I'm getting at? The LeBron 8 version 2s were 160, and they dropped in price when the version version PS, not version 3. Well, they're the version 3s, but the version playoff series. These dropped in price $10, but the LeBron 9 comes out, they're 170. They go up $10 from last year. But around the playoff times, they jump up 80 bucks. Ridiculous, ladies and gentlemen. And I want to shed some light on another shoe in the Elite series that I'm not seeing what the hype is all about. Okay, so this summer, June 2nd, the LeBron 9 Elite Series South Beaches are dropping. When I first heard about this shoe, I was like, okay, that's what's up. LeBron's finally listening, or Nike's starting to listen, saying that, okay, the South Beach colorway has gone crazy, and it's a very hot, popular shoe, so we're going to go ahead and drop another version of the shoe. But it's ugly. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, you can call me crazy what you want, but that shoe would never beat these shoes right here. Sorry. Sorry. won't do it. Like, you can say whatever you want about the LeBron 9 Elite Series. Oh, McCray, it's got gray in it. Still won't beat this shoe. Okay? It's got a different Air Max unit on the bottom. Still won't beat this shoe. I prefer the 360 Air Max unit on the, on the shoe, because it looked better. This shoe was absolutely beautiful. The LeBron 8 is one of the shoes, the shoes in the LeBron, line that are up there. This shoe, if not, is way up there, okay? But what I'm trying to get at, ladies and gentlemen, most of y'all are going to cop these South Beaches because of what these South Beaches did. Y'all going to cop those South Beaches, the LeBron 9 South Beaches, because of what this South Beach shoe has did. And I can't see, how y'all are even, justifying that shoe is hot. That shoe, no disrespect to females, looks like a female shoe. It looks like a shoe that a female will wear. As if the Summit Lakes didn't even look like a shoe that females wore, but it's all about hype, okay? It's all about hype. It's all about hype. People missing out on shoes and trying to make the next shoes bigger is bigger. Nike knows what they're doing. And if you don't believe me, cats are on Twitter right now selling South Beach slides. And y'all are buying them for $110 for a pair of flip-flops that you can paint yourself. South Beach colorway. And it'll be the same shoe. Hype kills, ladies and gentlemen. Y'all need to stop it. What do you think happens to a shoe? Here's a smart thing. If I know that these shoes are going to be $250, I'm not going to cop it. I'm going to be like, okay, at my, Foot Locker or whatever, I'm not going to cop them, because guess what? I want to make that shoe go down in price. But guess what's going to happen? Nike has to make their money. If they see a shoe's not selling on it, they will mark it down. They'll tell stores to mark it down. I promise to you. Alright? Now, this, if you don't believe me, the Cough Drop foam posits. One of the most plain color, foam posits, like everybody was saying. And I didn't cop them. I didn't cop them because they were plain color. But guess what happened? The Foot Action that I copped it from, probably a month later, they marked them down to 170. And I said, that's a justifiable price for a pair of phone posits, you know? But that's what I'm saying. That would be the smart thing to do. Don't cop the shoe. Let it hit the let them mark it down, or either, you know, the shoe will go to the outlets and watch. But y'all are copying shoes just to copy because, you know, a small group of people like it, or, you know, the hype for the shoe is catching on. You're not copying the shoe. Be honest. You're not copying the shoe because you want to copy it. You're copying the shoe because you see people on Twitter, Facebook, eBay, Craigslist put the shoe up there for $75 up, you know, above price. And I'm not hating on resellers because it's going to happen. But if you complain about the price, don't cop the shoe. It's like supply and demand. It's the basics. If they know the demand is there, they're going to supply it, but they're going to tweak it. They're going to put, that's why, this is what Nike is doing. Nike is putting the tweak on the price of the shoe. So my point is, man, cop the shoe if you like it. If you don't, leave it alone, you know, and everything will be back to normal. But as long as there are people out there are just going to, you know, you or people out there are going to just cop the shoe just because, stop it, man. It's not worth it. It's really not worth it. Like, the shoes I have, I cop because I like, you know. The LeBron 9 Big Bangs, I cop because I like, all right. I like the shoe, you know. It was different. Y'all not grasping it. Y'all just copping shoes and just gonna drive the price sky high, and then Nike ain't gonna have no other choice but to start coming for some of these reselling prices, because Nike does look at that. They look at what happens, you know, on Twitter, on Facebook. They do, and I can't blame them, but I can't blame the people that are hyping it. So just cut it out, man. It's not worth it. It's really not worth it to pay $250 for a shoe that just dropped that had the same effect last year, this year, you know? So that's my 2 cents, man. Let me know what y'all think about it. And God bless Chris for